Over the years, the country has marked International Women's Day in various forms. We have to admit that it has usually been led by civil society. And so the gender machinery saw it as very key, critical, to lead the process. And that is why we're saying that is the first Ghana Women's Summit that has been celebrated by government. But how do we move forward? How do we move on to achieve this gender equality? So that is what informed the summit.
Today is a historic day in Ghana. We have gathered here women from all walks of life, countries, political parties, professions, religious affiliations, ethnic groups, different colors, all here to celebrate the Ghanaian woman. Welcome, welcome, welcome to the Ghana Women's Summit.
Our Father, who made man in your image, women inclusive. Anything that concerns women, you hold dear to your heart. We pray today that everything that shall be done here, we will see its implementation for the betterment of this nation, for our women and for our children. Bless our minister who has organized this wonderful program and help us to be shining examples of the things we say and do. Thank you for answered prayers. In Jesus' name, and all shall say aloud, Amen. Amen. Bless you.
The summit under the theme Equality for Women is Progress for All through Total Inclusion is an initiative by the Gender, Children and Social Protection Ministry, which it intends to institutionalize. Nana Oyelitha tasked women to unite in diversity to achieve a much needed national restructure.
To ensure women continue to be empowered, we at the Ministry of Gender, Children and Social Protection, we are campaigning vigorously against gender-based violence. We recognize the role of Parliament, who have passed laws to protect our interests, the role of the judiciary, whose Supreme Court delivered a landmark judgment that has secured property rights of wives and women in marriage, the role of the media, who have consistently highlighted our issues.
Representing market women, Mercy Nijan said more market women are pursuing empowerment through formal education.
I'm highly privileged to be here this morning to add my voice to this Ghana Women's Summit 2014. In fact, formally, if there is an occasion like this and you see market women being invited, they will be invited to occupy the seats. They will be invited as the greatest to make the place full. Presently, you see what our women's minister, Hanabo Nana Oyelitha, is really doing. Appreciating the informal sector. In fact, it's long overdue when market women were taught to be illiterate, not knowing what they are doing. Presently, we have a lot of informal education. We send our women to seminars, take our women to courses, so that they will know exactly what they are about.
Speakers agreed. Although the judiciary tries to dispense justice in favor of women, legislation was the best solution.
Her Ladyship congratulates the Ministry of Gender, Children and Social Protection for such a bold step. She is especially happy about the inclusion of her male counterparts, without whom the vision of the ministry cannot be achieved. The courts have, in the appropriate circumstances, attempted to do justice even when Parliament has not enacted appropriate legislation as required by the Constitution. She wishes you God's wisdom as you do your deliberations. I thank you.
Member of Parliament for Puziga, Ladi Aye Ayamba, said those laws are being vigorously pursued by women in Parliament.
For some of us, we do not normally know how to express ourselves. When we see women, who maybe, and most probably, we would have seen only on television, and we have admired and emulated them. I can assure you, although I'm a member of Parliament, I have seen some women here whom I have admired over the years. And today, taking up to their activities, I have become a member of Parliament. They are women. Excuse me to say, we recognize the men, we agree there are men. But as women, let us appreciate ourselves.
Prayer coordinator for National Women's Aglow, Gifty Afenyidazi, gave biblical backing about the competence of women in leadership, asking government to do more to get women there.
They lead a woman called Deborah. And Bible said Deborah was a prophetess, the wife of Libetor, and then also leading Israel at that time as a judge. And therefore, wherein lies this assumption that women cannot be in leadership. Since creation, God believed that women have a role to play. Yes. And so, in Genesis 1 and 27, he created male and female and blessed them and said that we should take dominion over the land. And for me, I don't see myself as a woman. I see myself in the image of God. And therefore, anything that I want to do, I know that because God created me in his image, created you in his image, you are bound to succeed. You are not bound to fail. Today, I came to let you know that far away in Numbers 27, five women, Mala, Noah, Hogla, Mika and Tiza, five daughters of Zelophehad, they confronted the status quo. What was their beef? Their beef was that because their father had no son, when the father died, their inheritance was quashed. And then they appeared and went to Moses and said, Moses, we want to have audience with you. It is time for us to challenge the status quo. These five women went to Moses and said, Moses, you cannot, as it were, take our father's name from the property of the family. Moses said that this case is beyond me. And Moses took it before God. And God said, the women are right. Can you imagine if these five women accepted what had been handed over to them? We cannot accept what is being handed over to us. We will fight. Our mothers have been recognized today. It is for us to push, to push, to push for more space. Some of us have to push more for more space for freedom of expression. Others have done well. I recognize my mother here for pushing the space even in the religious arena. But I think to let you know that woman, thou art loose. Woman, thou art loose. Nana Oye, thou art loose. It does not matter. It does not matter the criticisms and the perception. I came to let you know that you can come out of the failure mentality. areas of Ghana. We shall arise.
We shall arise.
We shall arise.
We shall arise.
And we shall go forward. Because Ghana needs us.
Yes.
Amen.
Indeed, building our nation together. I wish to commend the Ministry of Gender, Children and Social Protection for organizing this first Ghana Women's Summit to provide a platform to celebrate the achievements of our women, draw inspiration for others, and speak about their challenges.
Oh, yeah. is your place. As old as you are, as old as you are. I am on the low side. I will never give up. I am an overcomer. For the Lord is on my side.
Hey, you to shake yourself.